Please stand up on your feet, everyone. So, pwede po ba tayo na tumayo? Okay, please. So, first po, of course, this is a very special day for everyone of us. Of course, I really want to acknowledge the hardship of the Filipino Institute management, Filipino Institute trainers, and of course, Filipino Institute graduates. You know, we really need a warm clap of applause para doon sa bawat isa. Yung milestone na nabit po ng Filipino Institute, producing 21,000 graduates of highly skilled Filipino professionals, you really deserve a standing ovation po, and for our founder, Sir Gabriel, and Dr. Arnan for being here tonight. So maraming salamat, and kailangan po natin sila ng malakas na palakpak. So makakaupo na po tayo. Siguro po matapos yung speech ko by tomorrow, so I hope kumain po kayo. Actually po, nung na-receive ko yung invitation to give a speech, I humbly accepted it. Hindi ko po ini-expect. And sabi po sa akin ni Dean Sheila, you really need to inspire students. So kailangan ko po daw kayong i-inspire. So nag-check po ako ng graduation speech. And isa po sa graduation speech na chinek ko ay yung kay Steve Jobs. Actually, the time that he delivered his speech in Stanford commencement exercise, sinabi niya po doon na binigyan po siya ng tanging ng doktor na mabubuhay na lang siya for the next 3 months or 6 months, and he's going to die of pancreatic cancer. So ako po naman, chinek ko, bakit kaya ako ang speaker? Hindi pa naman ako mamamatay. Anong tawag doon? Chinek ko po din, this week, meron akong medical check-up, blood pressure pa lang po naman yung na-discover sa akin. So, maintenance pa lang po ng blood pressure. So, hopefully, after 2 years, hindi pa po ako linisan. Okay? So, the truth is, I really want to share with you a story. You know? A young man, isang Filipino, of course, lumaki siya sa Pilipinas, at nanggaling sa mahirap na pamilya. Okay. His father is a member of Philippine Constabulary, and his mother is an accountant, but due to suffering of financial difficulties, problems in the family, his mother needed to leave the country to work as an OFW. So most of you, so lahat po tayo is dadaan din sa ganung sitwasyon, and I think this is one of the reasons why you are here. Because of your family, right? So yung pong mother niya, she keeps working and supporting the family. And then after that, ang nangyari po is, his mother decided to bring him in abroad as well, in Italy. So ang nangyari po is, dumating po yung bata at 17 years old sa abroad. And nakita niya po yung sitwasyon. So, his mother is hiding a secret. His mother is already suffering 2 years in the hospital. So, kabalik-balik na po pala yung nanay niya sa hospital. So, this young man at 17 years, wala pa naman siyang any education. He doesn't have anything on his hand. He doesn't have any diploma, any certificates, like the Filipino Institute certificates na ma-receive niyo. What he did is, he started at the very bottom. So he looks for job, cleaning jobs. And the first job that he took is, the second job actually, is a dishwasher. And the problem actually is, kailangan na umuwi ng mother niya for the medication. So umuwi yung mother. And then this young man at the age of 18, he started working and sending money for the medication of his mom. But the problem is, after 2 years of treating, you know, doctors in De La Salle, trying to treat the mom, but the mother died after 2 years. And at the same time, there's an encounter in the kitchen, in his work, no? Kasi syempre sa Europe, medyo mahirap magtrabaho, especially if you are working in F&B kitchen. Sino po nag-work sa F&B? Hindi po ba? So alam niyo yung pressure, di ba? And then, he's working with a head chef. The head chef maltreated him, abused him mentally and physically, but not sexually, okay? Okay, so there's one situation na nangyari po is, nanunood ng isang news, yung pinaka-head chef, and this young man, no, ina-ask niya lang yung head chef to borrow a newspaper, para magpasend yung newspaper, because he really wants to learn. What happened is, they got an argument. Ang ginawa ng head chef, kumuha ng boiling water and then throw at his face. Okay? At the first time. So yung young man is nakailag naman siya, hindi siya tinamaan. But on the second try, yung boiling water tumama sa kamay niya. Then he ran. Then this young man, he ran. And then the next day, he resigned from his job. And he said to himself, I will never be in this position again. I will climb the career ladder. I will not treat somebody na ganito yung linangas. And that dishwasher is important. So, Jonathan Ruiz po, ako po is currently living with my beautiful wife and two beautiful daughters. So, naniniwala po ako, success can be achieved giving the right character, attitude, hard work, and determination. And of course, I want to leave a parting guidance actually. The acronym PAM. So you've seen, I think, PAM Academy. The meaning of PAM, P is for planning. So there is a scripture attached to it. For Jeremiah 29 verse 11, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. So, your future is already planned. So, you just need to work on it. You are here because you planned for it. Second is the letter A for actions. So, take appropriate actions every day. Now, you took already one step ahead. Because you are going to receive a certificate from Filipino Institute, so meaning you took already the actions. Then M for mindset. So you need to have a growth mindset. It's really, I respect all of you, you really receive the honor, really deserve to be honored today because of your mindset. You think that you can do it, you can achieve it, you can excel in any area of your expertise, industry. You are here in UAE because you want a better future and a better life. So before I end my speech, actually, I want also to share, you know, this is a new work ko. Every morning, I'm going to pass this office, you know, head siya ng engineering department. And I always ask him the usual conversation, how are you, sir? And he always responds better than before. So then the next day, I will pass again, I will drop by. And he will say again, I will ask again, how are you, sir? Better than before. Then every day the conversation is better than before. Better than before. So I hope if I meet you somewhere or in the future, I will ask you the same question. I don't like to hear the word, I'm fine, sir. I would like to hear, I'm better than before. Go out to the world and say, I'm better than before. And tonight, you leave this place because you are better than before. Congratulations, graduates. Mabuhay po kayo. Ipagpatuloy mo, galing ng Pilipino. Ipagpatuloy mo. Thank you.